Such an honor to be here in Rome again. I was in Rome for different reasons a few months after my appointment as the Secretary General of Son Moi Young Youth. But I didn't really get an opportunity to meet and interact with young people and youth organizations in Italy. But it was more of a UN-focused event that I attended last time. So this is, I think it's safe to say that this is my real engagement with Italian young people here in your country. First of all, I'm very excited that you're launching the call for the next youth delegates from Italy to the UN. One, because youth delegates are a great asset that we have at the UN when it comes to advocacy at the global level, who helps us spread the messages of youth leadership across the member states. But I think even more so because I myself was a youth delegate many years ago. I was Sri Lanka's first youth delegate back in 2012. So I'm always very excited to meet youth delegates. I met your last two youth delegates in New York last September. And please count on my full support in terms of any guidance, advice, or mentoring that you might need in taking this process forward. Very happy to help. Going back to what we wanted to discuss today, youth and the 2030 agenda, there are many aspects in the 2030 agenda that I think that we can relate young people to, involve young people to, and really bring up case studies where young people actually leading the charge, taking action, because this is an agenda that we care about, that we are passionate about. It's about our future, it's about our planet. That's the only plan we have if we are serious about reversing climate change or ending poverty or ending hunger. The generations before us, yes, have achieved certain progress, but that progress has been step by step, incremental. But if we are to reverse all these scenarios and achieve true sustainable development, then we need transformative change. Incremental change will not suffice. And we are the generation who can bring about that transformational change. So I think it's really important having that at the core of our discussions when we talk about young people in the sustainable development agenda. So I'm speaking about the Sustainable Development Agenda, thinking that all of you know what the SDGs are. But if there's anyone who might not be familiar with SDGs, please raise your hand. So maybe we can do a very quick introduction. So everyone knows, right? So there's this saying that I always like to say. It is that it's the best of the times to be a young person, but it's also the worst of the times to be a young person in the world. And this is an analogy that I use to bring young people to the conversations around the 2030 agenda, which I will get into in a few minutes. I say it's the best of the times because, as I said before, we are the largest generation of young people that this world has ever seen. If you consider the people aged between 10 to 24 years, we are 1.8 billion. And if you consider all the people below the age of 30, then we are about half of the entire world's population. In countries like India, we have about 350 million young people. In countries like Somalia, more than 70% of their entire population is under the age of 30. So the world as it is younger than ever before. So we have a large cohort of young people on this planet right now, which definitely is a demographic bonus. And we are the most connected generation ever. None of the generations before us have been having access to technology like us, have been connected to each other and to connected to information like us. So we have that access to information, we have the power of connectivity, and we are the largest generation ever. So I call it the best of the times to be a young person, of course, if you have access to all these services. But on the other hand, we have about 600 million young people living in conflict-affected areas. We have about 65 million girls who are not going to school. Close to 400 million young people do not have access to basic health care services. Close to 25 million young people are on the move, either as migrants or as refugees. So, on the other hand, it's the worst of the times to be a young person because we are continuously facing with these emerging transnational challenges. So I use this analogy to place young people in two sides of the 2030 agenda. The first side is using that power of leadership, using that demographic power, and using that power of connectivity and access to technology that we have as a generation. I think that young people can be the best partners when it comes to implementing the Sustainable Development Agenda and also monitoring and reviewing the Sustainable Development Agenda. These are two areas we are yet to realize the fullest potential of young people in. And on the other hand, young people are also the beneficiaries of the Sustainable Development Agenda. Because as I said, there are many young people who do not have access to education, technology, or health services, or even face barriers when it comes to civic and political participation in their country. So young people are also in the other side of the coin, which is on the side of the beneficiaries. So how do we make sure that we place young people in these two sides of the SDG agenda, but at the same time harness their fullest potential? Is the question I think we should be discussing today in this dialogue. Maybe you can tell me some of the examples of your own experiences, what you are doing through the UN Association and different organizations. I was just introduced to Italy's first Young People's Peacebuilding Network, which was very recently established. Very excited to learn about that. I think that's the second network as such in the world. Which is a great achievement in the side of the Italian young people. So what are these youth-led, grassroots, homegrown initiatives that we see around us that can be scaled up to a global level? So this is definitely something that I'm interested in discussing today. And on the other side, where do you see the challenges, even if you want to come up with your own solution, even if you want to innovate new ideas, and really help your government to implement the SDGs, there could be some challenges that you face in the context of your own country or your municipality or your own community. So what are those challenges and how can we work together to resolve some of those challenges as the government, as the civil society organizations, as young leaders? How can we work together to resolve those issues, and how, for an example, I, as someone from the United Nations, can facilitate that process for you to demonstrate your leadership in these issues. That's what I'm extremely excited to discuss today. Thank you.
Thank you very much.